301 redirect WordPress without plugin. Hello and welcome. In this video session, I'm going to quickly show you how you can redirect your WordPress posts or pages using 301 redirection. Okay, and I'm going to show you to use it without plugins. Okay, so now what we need to understand is, regardless of the file name extension that you may be having on your WordPress site, okay, it doesn't matter what file extension you're using. When you do redirection, what you do is you simply copy this particular portion of the URL, and all you do is log into your hosting account. Okay, you may have different hosting provider, web hosting provider. It makes no difference, because 99% of them will allow you to have an option to easily do redirection. Now, bear with me, because if you've actually tried this and it didn't work, I'll show you why that is as well. So what you do is you simply choose 301 permanent redirection. That's the type of the directive. And you simply choose the URL, okay, and you simply paste that portion of the URL, okay, that we want to redirect to. Now let's say we want to redirect that particular page or post to this one here, okay. If that's the case, what we do is we simply copy the entire URL, okay, and we simply paste it, okay. It'll give you other options. These are pretty basic, okay, and all we do is we add redirection rule, and as you can see, that's added now. That means when someone visits this URL, they will go to this one here. So let's double check to see if it's working. Let's refresh that page, and as you can see, that's been refreshed, but our 301 redirection on our WordPress site, it didn't work. Well, why is that? I'll show you why that is. Now, you simply find the files where your WordPress site resides in. Usually, if it's in the main domain portion, it will be under public underscore HTML folder, right? And within that folder, this is where the core WordPress folders and files reside in, okay? And you will have WordPress automatically generating .htaccess file here, okay? Now, what we need to do is we need to quickly have a look at this. But if you're not seeing this, I'll actually show you another way to actually view that file. Let's say this is not here and you can't see it, okay? Because it's hidden files, okay? Some web hosting providers don't show these files, okay? So you may have it, but it may not be here. So if you're not seeing it, what you do is you simply locate any other file, and let's just choose this, and let's go into edit mode. Let's press edit, and what you can do to view your .htaccess file is in the URL portion of any file that you're viewing and editing, simply locate the file name. As we can see, there is the file name, but this is not the htaccess file, right? And what you can do, the easy way, is simply you delete that portion and just put .htaccess and then press enter, and what will happen is it then should show you the automatically generated .htaccess file. Now, as you can see, we've actually placed that 301 redirection through the option that we used before. As you can see, everything seems to be working here, but it's not redirecting. That's because what you need to do is you simply, let's close this. Actually, let's not close it. Why we close it? Because we didn't modify it. you can cut the code that we've created and place it above here. See, as you can see, this is automated, and that's the redirection rule. Okay, simply we press it above the automatically generated WordPress directives here. Okay, simply remember, don't modify this or else your entire WordPress site will go down. Okay, now what we do, let's press save. Now that's saved now, right? So that means what I'm saying to you is simply let your hosting interface help you create the redirection, and then go into htaccess file, .htaccess file, and then simply cut and paste it above this code here, and then you simply hit save. Now once you do, let's go back and let's hit refresh, and as you can see, that's now redirected using 301 without any plugins. That's how simple it is to use 301 redirection without any plugins, because plugins sometimes are useful, but if it's very easy for you to do the redirection without plugins, I strongly suggest that you actually don't use any plugins for redirection, because you may, the plugin may conflict with the theme or core files and so on, okay? And because WordPress gets updated all the time, your plugins need to be updated as well. So this kind of covers everything as far as any issues, rendering issues or WordPress issues, okay? Now, I also have this particular video here that actually explains what is the best way to do a 301 redirect. I strongly encourage you to watch this particular video session, because you will see how to really understand 301 redirection and do it properly, so that you can see the best results for SEO purposes and Google ranking purposes. I thank you very much for learning with me. If you own a WordPress site, I have other video tutorials. Don't forget to subscribe, because I will be adding more useful video tutorials so that you can grow your online business. Thank you very much for liking this video if you have benefited from it. I thank you very much. Happy rankings.